of the topic is how to get the IDE called as Anaconda. It's very simple. Go to your Google and type anaconda.com. Click on download. Again, click on download. So as we are using 3.7 version, so depends upon your system configuration, go and choose the right version of the Anaconda that you want. So click on download. You can able to download your Anaconda version. As I already have that, again I'm not going to download. Okay, as I told you to install your python.exe, it's going to be the similar fashion. You don't need to touch anything over there. Okay, so that is going to be a sequence of 2 to 3 steps. By clicking your next button, your Anaconda will get installed. Once you install your Anaconda, click on your start button and you can able to see a icon called Anaconda Navigator. So this Anaconda is going to behave like a server, guys. It's going to behave as server, like a server. So it is going to help you to open a web page where we can able to see multiple editors in that. So I'm going to show you how that Anaconda editor server is going to look like and how we can able to see different kinds of IDEs available on that. So wait for a while. Yes, my Anaconda is getting launched now. So now see, once I launch my navigator here, see here, you can able to see the multiple IDEs that are available here. We have Jupyter Lab, Jupyter, Qt Console, Spider, Visual Code. So with my knowledge, I can explain you. So for what purpose each editor is going to be used. Okay, so this Jupyter, right? This Jupyter is going to help you to work with your data analytics programs can be able to develop very easily. Okay, so with this Jupyter, similarly, right? This Spider also. So Spider and Jupyter both are going to be used in analytics area and data science areas. And Qt, right? PyQt. So this one is the one which is going to help you to develop a graphical user interfaces on the web-based applications. If you want to develop like any web-based components, then we can able to use your Qt console. And Visual Studio Code, I told you already, it is also one of the editor. So where people write to do the front-end development, in such cases, people are going to use this Visual Studio Code. And this glue is right to visualize your data, to analyze your data, and to conceptualize the visualization of data will be taking place by using your Glueviz. And R Studio is nothing but, okay, so like Python, we have another programming called as R. Prior to this, Python R is the one which is available in the market. Still, R have its own demand, which is going to be used on the data science part also. Okay, so if you want to develop your R programs, yes, this is going to be help you too. So this orange, I never came across to this, but with this explanation, I can able to tell that for data mining and data warehousing purpose. Okay, again, this is going to be part of your data visualization. You can able to use your Orange 3. Okay, so now for at this moment, I don't want to get enter into all type of IDEs. For you to make understand, to write your basic program, I recommend you guys to go with the Jupyter here. So click on this launch and wait for a while. Now click on this new and choose your Python 3. That's it. Now this is the time for you to write your code. So in every programming language, if you start right, we should be able to see a program called Hello World program. So what do you mean by that? It's a program which helps the user to check whether the particular program is able to give the output or not, whether it is installed correctly and your expected outputs are coming or not. So to do that, in every programming language, we'll be having a Hello World. Here also, I'm going to show you the Hello World program just to check whether my Python has been installed, whether my IDE has been installed correctly, and I'm able to get the output or not. Okay, so to check your output in Python, we'll be using a statement called print. So in this Python also, we have different versions. Before 3.0, we have a version called 2.0. In that 2.0 to 3.0, there are a lot of changes. So I don't want to discuss that because it's an outdated one where I'm not going to use anywhere. But I just want to tell about this print statement. This print statement in 2.0, right? In 2.0 version, we'll be using like this. So, but now in 3.0, what happened, right? This print has converted as a method, and it is mandatory for the user to print any statement in Python that has to be encapsulated in between these parentheses. Okay, so now the first topic that I learned is how to print any statement in my Python. Okay, so to save anything in your Python, you have to use your print statement. Now just click on your run. Yes, I can able to see my output in Python Jupyter notebook as Hello World. Similarly, we are going to see how to download your Pycharm. So the next topic that we are going to see is how to get the IDE, what you call as Pycharm. So this Pycharm is, again, it is the one held by JetBrains. So JetBrains is the one of the organization where they're going to help you in IntelliJ and this Pycharm editors. So those editors are very much prominent in the market, where people are using very lot in the market now. Okay, so Pycharm is again coming from JetBrains. Just go to your Google and type Pycharm download. This Pycharm is available in two formats. One is called commercial, another is going to be called as community. So commercial is nothing but provisional one. So community is the one which is going to be available for you free of cost. You don't need to pay for anything. As a beginner to start right, I recommend you to work few days on Pycharm, then move on to your Jupyter. Okay, so for data science part, when you come into data science part, anyhow, I'm going to teach you on Jupyter only. So for now, as a beginner, start working on your community edition with Pycharm. So click on this download. As I already have that, I'm not going to take any risk on that. Okay, I'm not going to download it. I'm going to cancel it. So once I download that, I'll be able to see my Pycharm version like this here, Pycharm community. So as how I told you earlier, how to download your install your Python, the steps are going to be common. But ensure that you have Python installed successfully on this. So right click on this. Again, run as an administrator, proceed for the last one, and your Pycharm is going to be installed. So once you install your Pycharm, just go to your start, click on this JetBrains Pycharm. Just wait for a while.
Okay, so like, just give me 1 second, Pratap. So, hello?
Now my Pycharm has been opened here. So this is the Pycharm which is already having a project. So in my case, how can I create a new project? Go to file. You should be able to see a new project option available here. Click on this. Thank you. So just create a folder called data science. So I'll be giving you a name here. Okay, let me click on create. I want to create a new window. So this is going to create a new workspace for you. Yes. Now your Python, Pycharm has been launched and your product has been created here. Now, where should I go and write my program? So to create your program, you should require a placeholder, right? Yes, I definitely agree Pycharm is a placeholder to develop. Okay, to write your programs, we should have a placeholder. So select your project, go to new, choose directory, and enter the directory name here. Enter the directory name. So I'm going to keep it as introduction. Click on OK. Now right click, go to new, choose your new Python file. Choose your new Python file. So here I'm going to use a name called intro. So as I said, you like to verify whether your Pycharm has been installed correctly or not. To check out that, we are going to use a statement called print and a message called hello. I'm going to use right click, run intro. So this is the going to call as console. Here you can able to see your output. Okay, so with this, I can able to conclude that my Pycharm has been installed successfully and it is running successfully. In some cases, if you are not able to see this output on Pycharm, what should I do? So what you want to do is go to file, settings, then here you should be able to see your project, expand this. Here you can able to see your project interpreter. Click on this plus symbol, this gear symbol, click on add. So here it is going to ask you to choose what kind of environment. Click on this existing environment, or if you want to change that, click from here new environment. You'll be able to see the browser. So where exactly your Python is installed, go there and choose your Python. I told you right in starting of the session, you'll be using your Python 3732. Okay, so you have to choose your Python 3732, python.exe. You have to choose this folder such that, right, automatically you'll be able to see these two things available here, pip and setup tools. These two are important to run your programs. So now click on OK. When you want to do this, only if you are not able to view this output. If you are not able to view this output, you have to go and change your interpreter settings there.
If you like the video, please like and subscribe and click on bell icon.